Get a body lock on me and flatten me. So we're gonna start. Bottom player has inside position with their feet, flatten your back, and top player has a body lock at your hips. Bottom player, I want you to keep your hands and feet on your partner. You're gonna look to win by getting your back off of the mat via becoming top player, or sitting up and unlocking your partner's hands. Come back. Top player. Top player, while staying on top, pulling your partner down and maintaining a connection to their hips, I want you to win by removing one of your partner's feet from your body. It could be beginning to split the legs with your knees, or it could be removing the foot and starting to go outside. Okay, we don't have to get in front of the knees yet. We're just trying to remove one foot from between the legs and either split their legs or bring their feet to the outside of us. Your locked hands are gonna help hold their hips still. But we can use our connection through our arms, but also wedging our head to either side of their body or just pinning them to the floor with our head as well. Okay? So don't get too caught up in like where your head is. Use your head to help hold them still, keep them down. Okay? 1, 2, 3.
Good to win. Keep going. TJ, lead with your knees to help remove his feet from between your legs. we're trying to sit up, get her back off the mat, and break his grips. Good. Split his legs with your knee or get both knees to the outside. Use your head, use your head, use your head. Your feet sticky to Ryan. Keep moving him, keep moving him, keep moving him. Good. Hold him still while you try to get your knee between his legs.
Go on your back. We're going to start in the same situation, and bottom player has the same tasks in one condition. Keep your hands and feet on your partner, keeping your feet between their knees. Get your back off the mat by becoming top player or sit up and break your partner's connection. Top player, we started with locked hands around our partner, using our connection with our arms and our head to help wedge him in place. This time you win by getting in front of both of your partner's knees. Go like half butterfly. So, actually, go on your back again. We don't have to keep our hands locked the entire time. As long as I'm keeping him on his back, of course, he can let go and interact with other parts of his body. And when it comes to hip height, you guys can start sprawling all the way down to try and remove his legs and get around knees. We can start taking our hips up off the ground or even trying to hop over and anything in between. When I say lead with your knees, it's probably kind of not the best direction we put you in. Lead with your feet and or knees, okay? Just like we use, I think I told you last week, lead with our knees sometimes to get to inside position. We're still trying to get inside position just from top. I can start leaning with my knee to cut inside. Start interacting with his feet, with mine, to get them out of the way. That being said, the more you're able to hold him down, stay on top, and just not fall down, you're gonna have more time to explore anyway. Okay, you guys understand? 1, 2, 3.
Between you and him. Don't let him get in front of your knee. Keep pushing, keep pushing. Sit up and break his hands open. Keep turning and keep turning and keep turning. Work to sit up. Sit up. Start splitting legs. Get in front of that knee. Start to get off your back. Get up, get up, get up, get up, get up. Keep rotating, start to get up. Start turning, start turning, start turning.
Go on your back. So we're going to start past one of our partner's feet with locked hands at the hips. It could be he has one butterfly hook and I'm splitting his legs with my knee. I could have one shin across my body. Go to half butterfly. Or some kind of like half butterfly situation. But the theme is I've removed one of his hooks off of me and I'm a little bit closer to in front of his knees. Put this a hook in. Top player, you win by going from getting in front of your partner's knees and going from the hips to the shoulders with locked hands. Doesn't matter where you connect your arms, as long as I'm locking my hands anywhere around something at his shoulders, you win. You can cover hips or not, it doesn't matter. You also win by getting chest to back with locked hands. Still just locking hands at the shoulders. Bottom players, the same wins for you. Keep your hands and feet in your partner and get your back up off of the mat by sitting up and removing my connections. Becoming top player, I'm also giving you the option of standing up to both hands off of the ground and feet on the ground. Just start turning away from me. You don't have to break connection if you try to stand up, okay? Protect your shoulders if you choose to stand up, because if I lock hands, it's still a win for me. Use all of the options you have at your disposal, reversing, sitting up with your back off the mat, or standing, because they're going to help each other, okay? If I can't knock them over and get back on top, maybe I have enough space to sit up. If I can't sit up, maybe I can use a little bit of destabilization help. Allow me to start rotating and basing up off the floor. And even if you don't get to the shoulders one time, stand top, wedge him in place as much as you can with your upper body, and just don't let him get his back up off the mat. Okay? 1, 2, 3. Feet on them. Start rotating and try to sit up. Get your feet between you and him. Start basing, start getting up. Protect your shoulders. Good. Back off the mat. Get up, get up, get up, get up. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Closer to his head. Keep getting closer. Off the mat doesn't have to be entirely off the mat. You can start getting it off the mat by rotating too. Okay? Keep that connection. Start getting your hips up off the floor. Side pin. So to start, bottom player, you're flat on your back, and both of your hands and arms are interacting with your partner's top arm. Your only job is to not let your partner lock their hands around your upper body and to fight and get your back off of the mat. We're not looking to reverse or get our legs back in front in any way. We're just trying to keep our head and arms from being covered and get our shoulder facing the ceiling and facing our partner. We can still use a connection to the floor to give us base and reinforce our rotation, but we're not allowed to put our knees, posts, or hooks on our partner during this game. Top player, you win just by locking your hands around your partner, anywhere around their upper body, head and arm. Double unders, just one arm, doesn't matter. I don't want you to cover hips, but you can go anywhere around your partner's body if for the reason your legs end up back in front. Just don't explicitly reset, but like just work back to a starting situation-ish, okay? Mm-hmm. 1, 2, 3. get his hands off of you. Use your knees to remove his arms. Your hands. Start covering his head. Get inside of his arms, go between his arms. Keep going, keep going, keep going. His top arm is your main focus. Keep your arms between his arms. Keep your arms under his head. Get more of your body between his elbows when you're swimming. Mm-hmm. Okay.
He has inside position on your arms. I want you to get inside of his arms. Hands, elbows, your head, your shoulder, your knee, doesn't matter. Start with our hands still on our partner's top arm, not letting him connect his hands around us, and not letting him cover our head with any part of his body, be it his arm, his torso, his hips, his legs. Do not let your head get covered. I'm still staying inside of his arms, but this time we're adding our knees inside. You're not allowed to put the bottoms of your feet on your partner to manage distance with posts. You can still use hooks to maintain a connection. It'd be hard to separate them anyway, but any part of the front of your legs can be connected to your partner. Bottom player, we're just trying to not let our partner connect hands around us. If you start getting your knees out of the way, push, make space. Keep more of your body between his arms than he is getting his body between my arms. Top player, no covering hips still. You can go anywhere around the body, it doesn't matter. Again, if you start ending up with the feet in front, don't stop explicitly, just work to the constraints. Top player, you still win by locking hands around your partner, but I want you to prioritize figure four connections and head and arm connections. Head and arm meaning there are wedges on both sides of my head and arm. It doesn't matter what shape it's in or where it comes from. Just want you to either get a figure four connection or connect your arms anywhere you want together, as long as you are creating head-arm connection, and there is a wedge on one side, and the body, okay, doesn't matter. If you get to situations like the previous game's win conditions, keep going until you get to the figure four or a head and arm with wedge. Especially for top players, I feel like you need this focus as well. His legs and arms are in the way of trying to get to his torso. I'm trying to get inside of his hips and legs. I'm trying to get inside of his arms. It doesn't matter what I'm using. My arms. My head. My legs. It really doesn't matter. I'm just trying to put some or more of my body between these spaces. Okay? don't rush. You need to take your time and try to swing through. I'd rather you stay closer to the end rather than rush and get pushed back from it. Okay? Ryan has to go to you, okay? Stay inside of his arms and elbows. Get onto your side and push him away. Get your knees back inside. Figure four, or connect your arms, run head and arm with wedges on both sides. I can't say it's wrong. That's
right. It's not the best one.
Hey, you never know.
pushing and turning. Get something between his arms. Stay standing. So standing disconnected first game. You're both going to try and do the same thing, which is get an asymmetrical connection to your partner with locked hands. It could be to a leg or both, on the body, front or back. If it is something neutral like this, you can continue until it's uneven. Lock your hands. This is symmetrical. Keep your arm up. This is uneven. Front headlocks do not win, but we can still use these to try and get to some other uneven connection.
Can you explain that again one time? When you're like, when I'm like here?
So really, we're a mirrored thing. Like this is a 50-50, but if I'm able to unlock your hands,
oh, I see. I gotcha.
That's really the only way I can think of phrasing that too. I'm still trying to think of a body lock like that. But yeah, you guys understand?
Yeah.
Okay. 1, 2, 3.
the elbows out of the way. Push, pull, rotate.
Still. We're still standing disconnected. This time we're going to use our connections to bring our partner's hips to the floor to win. If you're going to level change, keep facing your partner. I don't want you guys diving to the floor because now my chest is facing the ground. If you're going to level change, I want you to use it to come up under your partner, not go down to the floor. So he's like pushing into me, whatever, I'm getting his hands out of the way. Use it to scoop under the hips. Don't get stuck under his hips. When you start making connections, more forward pressure. He's just pushing back in, pull him to the ground. If he starts backing away, start backing up. You turn or turn him. Push, pull, turn, I think is a good framework to keep in mind when wrestling. So again, we're just trying to down the hips. Any connection you guys want, get his hips to touch the floor. Doesn't matter. Okay. One thing to focus on as well. Get the hands out of the way, or get out of the way of the hands. Keep it front. Okay, move them or move around them, but get these things defending his torso and legs out of the way somehow. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Just get your partner's hips to the floor.
Point your hands at him, be first. Push, pull, rotate, get them moving. Get their leg. Point your hands at them. Keep them folded, keep them folded. Keep your feet in the floor. Get underneath or get behind JP. Get under his legs or get around his legs. Hips close. As soon as you make a connection, use it. Be first. His elbows out of the way. Move him out of the way or move around him. Cover your head, Ryan. Run it across or pop it up to the side. your hips in, get your hips in, get your hips in. Get closer, get closer. Are the level changes. Keep your arms between you and him longer. Even on a disengagement. I do it too, it's not great, in my opinion. Keep them in front of you. Okay. I think you get people can get too relaxed. Like Joseph versus Hulk. They're like tying up, breaking away, tying up, breaking away, tying up, breaking away, and all of a sudden Hulk's like,
yeah,
gets a little too relaxed.
Okay.
Starting standing with a connection. One player you have. A body lock, and a body lock, and your partner has inside position with their feet. Body locking player, you win. Excuse me. Keep your hips and shoulders as close to your partner's hips and shoulders for as long as you can, and I want you to continuously look to, while using the body lock, pick them up for as long as you can, or cause any degree of posting to a hand, an elbow, a knee, or a hip. I'm just trying to get any part of his body that isn't his feet to touch the ground. Come back. And I want you to use splitting your partner's legs to help you achieve this. Overhooking player, you win by breaking your partner's connection to you and getting to a hand fighting range. That means he is far enough away where he doesn't have an underhook. You can still have a connection, it's just not shoulder to shoulder range, it's going to be hand fighting range. Or down your partner's hips. That means if I start splitting his legs from front or back, he unlocks his hands and posts. Keep your feet. The game continues until I make his hips touch or I break away to hand fighting range. Regardless of who, this is for both players, you're trying to down your partner, you must fall second. That means regardless of who we are, splitting in front or behind, you have to be the second one to hit the mat. I don't want you guys falling onto each other's joints and limbs. Splitting. Splitting. Be second to fall down. Okay? Really try to, as double underhook, as body locking player, pick them up for as long as you can. Okay? If you have the body lock, pick them up for as long as you can, or make anything but their feet touch the ground. Body locked player, you only win if you break away or you down their hips. Okay. So he can post a hand. If he's still close enough, the game continues.
But if you're body locked, you get him to the hand.
This one?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. So if he's still connected to me, I cause posting. Yeah. The game continues until I break away to further, or maybe I keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. Yeah, I can only win by breaking away or downing his hips. He can win by anything touching the ground. Okay?
Pick me up as a win.
It's not a win, but it's a task I want to continuously do. Okay. Hopefully it's good. 1, 2, 3. Keep your hips and shoulders close.
To use the body lock as body locking player. Remember, if you are getting body locked, if anything touches the ground but your feet, you lose. Okay? So no hand posting Uchimatas, nothing like that. Get your hips in, split his legs. Good. Keep going. If you take him down, you have to fall second. Push, pull, rotate. Make him touch anything to the floor. Keep splitting his legs. Watch the wall, watch the wall, watch the wall. Just rotate, rotate, don't disconnect. Good, go. Get back to the body lock. Good. Don't look at the floor. Connect to him, JP. Keep splitting the legs, keep splitting the legs. Hey, keep going, keep going. Break away or down his hips. Good. Split his legs, lift him for as long as you can. Make anything touch the ground to win. Good. Actively split his legs and pick him up. Get your hips closer. Pick him up, pick him up, pick him up. Start a bit more vertical for both of you. Okay. Don't start as hinged this time. Step in front of him. More. Hamza versus the leech, just pick him up. Split his legs, get under his hips, pick him up. lift, lift, lift. Pull him backwards. Pull him back, pull him back, pull him back. Don't crowd your lungs. Get your ribcage moving. You guys can start with any single leg you want, between your legs or on either side of your body, at the knee or foot, it's up to you. You win by getting your partner's hips to the floor or locked hands behind both of their elbows. You don't have any specific thing I really want you to do other than hold them toward the ground or get them as high off of the ground, keep facing, or get them as high off of the ground as you can. Sorry, you okay?
Yeah.
That mid-range where he has a lot more movement, control over his leg, I don't want that. I want the extremes of get down or get up while playing this. And of course, again, locked hands behind. Defender, you win by freeing your leg to hand fighting range. That means maybe he lets go of my leg but has an underhook. The game continues until I break away to hand fighting or he meets one of his conditions. Reversing. Or submission counter. Start in any single you want, wherever you want. Bring it to the floor or jack it up. Down his hips or lock your hands behind his body to win. Defender, submission counter, reverse, or breakaway to hand fighting range. If you cover his head, keep it covered. Okay? One, two, three. Yank it to the ceiling or push it to the floor. Nothing in between. Keep going, get behind or get back to the leg. He's got to break away from you. Don't look at the floor.
in, hips in, hips in. Get closer. Lock in front. Step in front, step in front, step in front. Don't stop, don't stop. Get to his legs with your legs. Keep it covered, keep it covered, keep it covered. Going. Good. Escape, reverse, or submission counter. Don't look at the floor. Uncover your head, Ryan. Get under him or peek your head out to either side. Just get it uncovered. Better. Get to the legs. Keep going, keep going. Good. Hold it tight, hold it tight. If you reverse, just fall second. Good. If you get your head covered, use movement to protect yourself. Okay? Jack it up to the ceiling or shove it into the floor. Nice, good. Stay on it, stay on it. Closer to his leg. Weigh it to the floor. Weigh his hips to the floor. Yes. Yes. How did that last two exchanges feel? Because you both kind of like pressured the hip down.
It was good. Felt like it was instant. Everything.
Was it the same sensation when I
demonstrated? Like it felt like very, very strong. Like the initiation was right there. There was no like fat or like pausing. Like a glitchy kind of.
Because I feel like if you can get on one of those early, like if you can start one of the movements early, usually you can like win that. I wasn't really having like a lot of luck. I feel like if he grabs my leg and he wants to jack up to the sky, it's pretty hard for me to defend.
Like even though we're standing, it's still some degree of immobilization, right?
Yeah.
Like if someone's got a noodle leg,
yeah.
It's hard.
Yeah, exactly.
But if you can hold the leg in a way where they can't move it as much, like, all right, then you can start working.
I think the most apparent thing to do is to pull their leg towards the mat because associated with their foot posting, but it's very destabilizing.
It's like splitting your bind, right?
Yeah.
The banana peel.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly.
Well, I was trying to do that, wasn't it? Like, I feel like you showed, you can pull or push really well, and you can get them thinking about like fighting your hands, and then just like keeping your one foot on the ground makes it pretty hard to.
Yeah, that also brings like, there's more probability, I feel like, that their feet come close, the more they're trying to visualize the feet. The closer together, it's easier to take out both in one shot.
Well, pyramids are
wide
and strong, right? Things are taller when they're narrower. Go double knees down and in on a single leg. So we'll start. We both have both of our knees on the floor. Our partner has his hands locked on her leg. I want you to rotate between head outside and head inside. Head covered, head uncovered. Bring your knees closer. Top player, I want you to start. No specific connections to your partners with locked hands, but just drape over them in any way you want, feet or knees. Top player, you win by getting behind your partner and their elbows. You don't have to lock your hands. Getting on top of them, down in their hips. You don't have to get to any specific pin, just get your hips above theirs with theirs on the ground. Or any submission counter to a submission, or use it to get to your other conditions. Bottom player, you win by getting behind your partner and their elbows. You don't have to lock hands, or downing your partner's hips and staying on top. You don't have to get to a pin. Put your knees again. We're still using push, pull, rotate. Ryan starts pushing into me, I start pushing back. Ryan starts pulling my leg out, I try to pull it back. Ryan starts trying to turn and get behind me to rotate and pivot. I'm doing the same thing. Use push, pull, rotate in those combinations. Go to your knees. This is not top position for Ryan. He has to get his leg free, let's say, and get over me to win. It doesn't have to be a pin, but I want to be clear. You can put your hips on the mat to help get behind your partner if you have to. Do you guys understand that distinction?
Yeah.
Okay. You guys understand?
Is it always for the guy that's down with that single leg, is he always head outside?
Rotate between head in and outside each time, uncovered or covered. Okay. One, two, three. Top player, get behind, get on top, or submit. Bottom player, get behind, or get on top. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going.
I thought he fell on your leg for a second.
I don't know.
Get under his hips or go around his hips. Good. Keep going. Don't stop. Ah. Good. Don't let your chest face the ceiling. Keep it facing the floor.
Good.
good. Get under him, get under him, get under his hips. Keep going. Move your hips, JP. Move your hips. Get your butt in the air and start running. Keep your hips high. Fight his elbows, fight his elbows. Keep turning, keep turning. Get back in the legs. Get back in the leg. Good. Get up. Good. JP, start with your elbows closer to your knees. Yeah. Switch off, switch off, switch off. Get underneath him. Good. JP's on top. Same thing, Ryan. Bring your elbows closer to your knees. Knees closer to elbows, yeah. Keep it laced. Keep his head covered. Good. Stay on it. Good. Go standing. So, stand squared with me a little bit. Yeah. Starting, hugging our partner's near leg. It's between our elbow and our body. Bottom player, you win by standing up. You don't have to stay connected. Becoming top player or submitting on the upper body. We can still use leg attacks to help us stand, get up, or attack the upper body, but we're just not finishing on the legs. A I want you to get your feet and or knees on your partner to manage space. And keep them away from you so you can start making more and more distance to stand up or get on top. If you can't get your feet on them, get your knees on them. And we're starting with this. We're starting with this, but just as like any non-specific leg situation, if he's covering my feet, I'm trying to get my knees to the inside. If he's pinning my knees, I'm trying to get my feet on him. On your back. Top player, you win by locking your hands anywhere around your partner's body, front or back, torso, shoulders, doesn't matter. I want you to get inside of his armpits. And it doesn't have to be diving directly on something, right? You can start to get low and keep his elbows and knees out of the way while we work to clear his connections and get closer and closer to his torso. Anything locked hands around any part of his body is a win for top player. And of course, hold him down since he's trying to get back up. Start covering him, even if you're not getting to his torso. If Ryan starts trying to get his legs in between us, I'm still trying to cover my partner, even though I'm not chest to chest yet. I'm still getting closer and closer from standing to the ground. Closer, 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 closer. Okay? You guys understand? One, two, three.
Bottom player, stand reverse or finish on the upper body. Top player, stand top, hold them down, lock your hands anywhere around their torso, head, or arms. Good.
Am I facing him this way?
Face his... step back a little bit, be square with his shoulder line. Yeah. Yep. Get your feet and knees on him right away. Lead with your knees, lead with your knees. Use it, use it, use it. Keep your feet out the middle. Get up. Lock your hands around. Get to the shoulders. Even though we can't finish in the legs, we still have to respect the threat. Open his feet. Keep facing, keep facing, keep facing. Right away. Can't get your feet in, get your knees in. You can't get your knees in, get your feet in. Keep rotating, keep rotating, keep rotating. Nice. Rotating can be turning, but it could be pivoting like a top too. Keep facing. Keep turning, yes. Keep facing, keep facing. Nice. Use it to get on top or stand up. You don't have to be connected to stand. Stay between those legs. Stretch it, stretch it, stretch it, stretch it. Get your back off the mat, JP. Separate his hands. Keep it, keep it, keep it, keep it. Get up.
Sorry.
Keep them off your shoulders. Good. Get your knees in. Good. Right away. Get him in. Good. Get his head away from you. Start getting underneath. Time. Realize the toenail that I broke the top of, my whole toenail is broken. It's like, man, why is it colored all weird? Fuck. That's gonna really fucking suck.
Your toenail looked a band-aid, blew that shit.
Yeah. It's funny, I checked chronometer, like, it's like my fitness battle that shows you micronutrients.
Yeah.
Only things I'm deficient in are zinc, magnesium, and calcium.
That's the gross stuff though, man.
This explains why.
Zinc's really important. I mean, all that stuff is, but zinc's really important. I take it every day. And magnesium. Calcium, I feel like I drink enough, like, dairy, but I got a supplement problem.
It can't be dangerous. Like, why can't they just make a multivitamin that meets 100% of everything so that even if you do get the other stuff from food, it's not dangerous? Like,
it's just because it's not bioavailable. And usually supplements are not as bioavailable.
Yeah.
Even if you take a full vitamin, you're probably not getting most of it. You pee most of it out. That's the shitty thing, is like you pay so much money for good vitamins, you end up peeing most of them out.
It's funny, most medications I think can last decades after the expiration date. The supplements, I feel like those things decay so fast. I don't know why I think that. Feet back on the feet, non-80cc rules. First to score. You can pull guard, you have to make a connection, submit, takedown, pass the guard, or positional score.
So you can pull guard without no connection?
You have to make a connection.
Okay.
Non-ADCC rules. Eight.
Okay.
Ascension, Naga, whatever.
Okay.
Go. First to score. Submit, pass to a pin, or takedown. Play the game. Don't let Ryan get up. Good. Reset. Nope. No. Reset. Back away from each other 5 steps. Shake hands, back away, then go. Go. Take your time. It's okay to be boring. Knees and elbows in inside. Stay over Ryan. Keep building. Get back up. Good. Reset. Same thing, start apart from each other, shake hands, back away, then go. Come back. Good. First to score. Take down, get to a pin, or submit. Be annoying. Keep his head covered. Stay on it. Go to him. Keep it covered. Separate the hands. Get his hand off you. Start getting your back up off the mat and facing his hips. Get your shoulders off the mat. Keep going. Get up. Good. Reset. Baru, wait. Go. Don't get your hips to the floor. Your hips touch, get right back up. Get up. Shake hands. You gotta score. Time.
That's class. So you can make it alone.